Hannah Neto.
This is William Lott.
I'm Rosemary.
And I'm Michael Yule.
And this is our project, Series in Parallel Circuits.
Right. Woo!
Hope you like it.
We're going to be talking about a couple different things. Main focus is going to be resistance, what it does, how it works, and just current, just again, what it is and how it works. So start off with our current is just charge over time. We use I for current. That's charge Q over time. And so that's the basic definition of current. It's measured in amps. And resistance is almost like electrical friction in that it's gonna slow down that voltage or that current. Resistance is also determined by the material. So if you have a wire made of copper, iron, or whatever other kind of stupid material, it's gonna be affected, or that's going to affect the resistance, and it's also dependent upon the area. And so that's how we get resistance. Most of the times it's already going to be measured, but this is just your background so you know like what's going on, how they're measuring that. And so putting this all into formulas, your current is equal to your voltage over your resistance, and that's as simple as it gets. Now we're going to talk about these that we have written up here or drawn out up here. This one, this circuit has resistors in series. And obviously we got three resistors right here. These are the symbols that we use for resistors, and they're all in series because they're all connected. There are no breaks or no diverging paths through each resistor. And then over here we have resistors in parallel. These are broken. They got different paths, different diverging paths. So that's how this is in parallel. And when you think of parallel, it's almost like a ladder. So when you see something that is built like a ladder, it's parallel. They're all right behind each other. That's in series.
All right, so here we're looking in a series circuit. We're gonna look for the total resistance here. So we're gonna go, this is gonna be your first resistance, your second one, and your third one. So we're gonna go R1 plus R2 plus R3. It's all gonna equal that. Right here. So the first resistance is gonna be 2 ohms plus the 4 plus the 2, which is all gonna equal 8 ohms. And from here, we're gonna look for the current. So the current equation is gonna be I equals V over our equivalent. We already have our V, which is gonna be 10 volts. So all we're just doing is plugging and chugging. It's gonna be 10 over the 8 ohms that we just found, which is gonna equal 5 over 4, which gives us 1.25.
So we're gonna find our R equivalent on a parallel circuit. So your first, your R1 is 2, your R2 is 4, and your R3 is 2. You have the formula where that'd be 1 over R equivalent equals to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. And then you get the answer first, and then you have to do the inverse of that in order to get the R equivalent for a parallel series. So you plug in your numbers. You have 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 2. 2 over 2 plus 1 over 4. And then you're going to have 4 over 4 plus 1 fourth, which equals to 5 fourths ohms. But since the 1 over R equivalent is equal to 5 over 4, R equivalent is going to equal to the opposite, which is 4 over 5 ohms. And that's your answer. So your I is going to be equal to your voltage over your R equivalent. So this is going to be equal to 10 over 4 over 5 ohms, 10 volts. So from here, you can just do the opposite, which is 10 times 5 over 4. 10 times 5 is 50 over 4. You can simplify that. You're going to have 25 over 2.
Now that you've learned how to solve series and parallel circuits separately, I'm going to show you how to solve a problem that combines both of these principles. And to make this easier to solve, I'm going to use Kirchhoff's rules. So, for Kirchhoff's rules, the first one is applying the junction rule. As you can see here, our junction point would be in this area right here. So for me to show you guys what's going on, current I3 coming in this way, but it starts to split off into two different directions. And so that's when you know that could be a good junction point. Okay, so you can go ahead and write this equation down to solve these currents. Now that we apply the junction rule, the second rule of Kirchhoff is the loop rule. As you can see, we have one loop, which is encircling the entire circuit. Then you have two separate loops. So I will denote them. It's one, two, and three. Now, from the negative side of your voltage and go to the positive, then your total voltage is going to be positive. And, you know, they're pretty straightforward. For current, if you decide to go one way with your loop, counterclockwise or clockwise, if it goes with the current, then your voltage is going to be negative. And if they both go opposite direction, then it's going to be positive voltage. So for the first one, we're going to start with 12 volts right here from this point. So as you see that it's going from negative to positive, then you can denote that as positive. All right, and so you're following the current. Since we're going with the current in order to do this loop, then we're going to denote that as negative. So we have, since these are series, you can just add them. So it's going to be 4 ohms. So since I'm following my current, to complete this loop, I have two resistors in series. Like so, we just add them. If we're going with the same path, it would be denoted as negative. So I3 is 6. And then we complete the equation at this point right here. We complete the loop. So since it's going from positive to negative here, you denote that as negative 4. And that will equal to 0, since that completes your loop. So we already have one equation. Well, two equations really, but we have three unknowns, so we should at least try to get three equations or more. So for the second loop, start out with this one. I will start here. So I'm going to go against the current this time. So this is your third equation, and usually you can be done with these three equations, but to complete all these loops, and just to be sure, we're gonna do the third loop. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do it for you guys. To finish this off, instead of boring you with simple algebra, you can just plug this into matrices. So,
and these should be the values that you get in amps. Once your calculator solves these. And that should be it.